in the interest of time, we'll just motor right along.
Do I have to use the mic? Do I have to use the mic?
Yes.
Yeah.
I don't want to be the wedding singer. You don't want me to sing. So thanks, John, for the introduction. And yes, I do blog quite a bit, but there's an easy way to do it. And I know you had a session on social media yesterday, and I would have loved to have participated. To see how the community uses social media to promote awareness, prevention, and create access to your clientele. But what I could have done, I didn't want to appear rude sitting there, I could have just taken my BlackBerry, sent an email to the site called ping.fm, and what it does is it is an aggregator of social media sites. So I send one email, and I was going to write, I'm speaking at the St. Chris Staff Assembly, and we've gone to over 100 social media sites like that, which equates to my sphere, a couple thousand people. And for example, one of my discussion items is about H1N1, and there's a couple thousand posts on who's doing it, who's not, what's the problem with the rollout, and it's just a way of creating a conversation in a very easy way that I could have started right here on my BlackBerry. So it's a very non-intrusive tool, and I don't spend hours on it. Really, it's literally, it could have been a minute. 30 seconds of typing 140 letter email. So, and that's the kind of style I'm gonna take with this presentation. Not a lot of words, and hopefully I can communicate the message. This is, getting away here. Full circle. My grandmother came to this country 40, 50 years ago as an immigrant, and benefited from the society in a multicultural way. I certainly benefited, my family's benefited from my grandmother coming over. What's interesting to note is my grandmother was actually a St. Christopher House client, and she participated in some of the social programs early on in the original Chinatown. And so there are very few Asian or Chinese of Chinese heritage that knew where to go for social programs. So St. Christopher House, and I remember because I would go to her, she had a hair salon in Kingston Market. Pieces of paper with St. Christopher House. At the time, I didn't know anything about St. Christopher House, but it would show some activities and things that they were doing. And it wasn't until recently that I've been working with St. Christopher House with the Home at Last program that I realized what a wonderful agency and organization this is. And the reason why is because of all of you that provide these services to a wide variety of residents in the city. But my grandmother actually lived to 107. So lots of stories. She's a talker. I'm a talker. Hopefully I get some of the good genes of living long. But her longevity speaks to what I'm going to talk about today, and it's the third wave. And I'll explain what the third wave, coupled with the triple whammy. So we're kind of having this convergence of the perfect storm in healthcare. And my grandmother is somewhat of a story to help frame this conversation. So the third wave, it's a little bit of history here. In the first wave, earlier in the century, the biggest health issues were public health. And ironically enough, public health issues are still very much paramount today with this new pandemic. So originally, in the early part of the century, we thought we had eradicated all the major infectious diseases, measles, mumps, diphtheria, yellow fever, with mass immunization programs around the world. And we thought mankind had conquered and moved on. And what it did, the implications of immunization programs, and I'm not advocating for or against, because that's been a topic of the blog, whether immunization programs are effective or not. But what it did was it lengthened the life expectancy from 65, early in the 1900s, to about 75, right across the world. So that was the first wave of the of healthcare, where public health took a foundational role on how we view healthcare in our society. Second wave started around the 50s, and it's the medicalization of healthcare, where hospitals became the cornerstone of our system. Our bodies became body parts. If you had a head issue, you go see your neurologist. If your arm was broken, you go see your orthopedic surgeon. If you had a heart problem, you go see your cardiologist. If you have a foot issue, you go see your podiatrist. So basically, we took our bodies, we cut it all up, and we said, you do this, you do that, and but who's really looking after the whole? And we're very much still in this second wave. We haven't moved away from it at all. But what this did was it also helped increase the life expectancy from 75 to roughly 85 on a whole. And this was through a lot of research and development, a lot of emerging technologies, so diagnostic imaging. You don't call it x-rays anymore. X-rays are from the 50s. It's diagnostic imaging. It's all computerized. You sit in this thing and it scans you like Star Trek, and it shows you all your insides. And from there, the body part physicians can look at what's wrong with you. So to a certain extent, we're still in here. We haven't cured cancer. HIV is still prevalent. Coronary heart disease, the incidence and prevalence, still increasing. Diabetes, the number one killer in this, number two killer in this country behind cancer, and a recent government priority. So despite the advances in medicine, we're still very much in a second wave. And so while we're still stuck there, the third wave is here, and what are we gonna do? And so what is that third wave? It's the aging population. Growing old should be fun, right? And it's clean, right? It's okay. You never know, right? Someone might be offended, so if you're offended, I apologize. But the statistics show the third wave is the aging population. And you've heard this in the media, and it's very true, that the baby boomers are now in that target population of 65 years and over. In this LIN itself, so the LIN is a regional body cut up from the City of Toronto and other municipalities. Yeah, so Local Health Integration Network, it's a regional body that is used to transfer funds to health service providers and plan and organize health services within a geographic boundary. And our Local Health Integration Network, or LIN, is your catchment area for St. Christopher House and Wood Greens and so on. So within our, we'll call it the City of Toronto to make it very easy. There's 141,000, there was in 2006, 141,000 in the seniors population, with a huge blip around that 65 to 70 year old catchment.